Hello, this is Corey at NinjaLot here delivering practical steps to total freedom. Now, if you did not see my previous video that was on the 4 steps to total freedom, I recommend checking that out because this is based upon that, but this is going to go over what I'm doing for those 4 steps, essentially over the next couple years, next couple months as well. I'm going to be creating a lot of different projects, and I figured why not just throw them out all on the table right now. Let's just show them for the world, show people what is out there, and maybe they want to get started on some of these. Maybe they want to collaborate, reach out to me. I look for people who want to collaborate, and a lot of the things I'm going to present here are pretty darn collaborative. Okay, it says here on the slide, it says note it's to assist the efforts in step 1 and 2 of the 4 steps. So the video I talked about, the last video, was 4 steps, and those 4 steps, number 1 was represent, number 2 was educate, number 3 was defend, and number 4 was show. So in this presentation, we're gonna go over what I'm gonna do for step 1 and 2, that is representing and educating. Okay, so this is going to increase our efforts in that. And if you notice in that previous presentation, it said on step 2 for education that it requires strategy. It's known as the strategic step, because you have to configure, well, how is it I'm going to educate people? How is it that this information is going to get out to more people? And if you doubt that total freedom is possible, well, I do recommend checking out that video because it is possible. And this is just among those steps. Okay, so let's jump right into what I plan on doing over the next couple months to the next year. Okay, the next slide here, we have number 1 is the summit. Okay, so if you haven't heard of the summit, I did a video talking about introducing this and saying, well, hey, if you are a passionate speaker, you love freedom, you want to share it with other people, I have created a summit. Now, this summit, it has a lot of information about it. Go to nita.one/summit-guidelines, and you'll see there's a whole PDF you can download, and you can actually share it with anybody you think would be a good speaker on topics such as freedom, ownership, slavery, etc., anything in between. And maybe you are a really good speaker at that. Maybe you feel like you have some sort of expertise or a story to share. Well, then look into it. I recommend filling out the form. It's only like 4 questions, basically. You just got to email me your answers. It's really, really basic. It's only 1 page of information. Like I said, 4 questions you have to answer. So it's very basic. Now, what is a summit? A summit takes place over multiple days, right? Once we get enough speakers, enough people that I interview with my co-host, or if it's just me, it depends on what's happening in the schedules, then what we're going to do is we're going to have the summit, and we're going to say, okay, this is the set day. These are the set days of the week where we're going to have this amount of speakers on this day, this amount of speakers on this day, this amount of speakers on that day. Right, and anybody who registers to this summit will also receive free gifts. 1 gift free from every single presenter, because in the 4 questions you have to answer as a somebody who's going to join the summit, you have to give one of your gifts, something that you created, something that you have to offer for people that you want to give away for free in the summit. Okay, so you have that, you have the summit, right? And when you register for the summit, you not only get those free gifts and you then get emails for each day the summit occurs, but you also get an automatic subscription to the newspaper, the Liberator 2. The Liberator 2 is a newspaper I'm starting out, and it's called an educative newspaper. That's number 3 on this list. Okay, now the Liberator 2 is a long-term project, meaning it's going to come after the summit. And it's going to be something where anybody can contribute, not just the speakers of the summit. And it's going to reoccur weekly. There's going to be an edition of this newspaper. And, you know, it's not going to take many people to contribute to it per week, like 2 or 3 minimum. And then we'll see if it grows, right? Okay. And every article that gets produced, because I wanted to provide an incentive for people to write, I will turn that into a video for them. I'll do narration and everything and give them full credit. I won't be seeking any donations for the newspaper. All the contributions will go directly to the people who contribute to the newspaper. And like I said, I'll be plugging their links, I'll be making videos for them. So it's a win-win scenario for everybody. You know, I put on my channel, but it's for them. I give them credit, and everybody's contributing to this one educative worldwide online in real life newspaper. I think it's a really cool idea, and I can't wait to get that started. But it's going to happen after the summit. It's good because if we have a base around the summit and we already have a lot of people knowing about it, then we could easily transition into the newspaper idea. But not only that, we have number two on this list, which is the status testimonies. So for each person who joins the summit and we do interviews with these speakers, I'm going to ask them, I'm going to say, well, hey, how did you not become a statist anymore, right? How did you realize what statism was? How you got out of the statist mentality? If we have statist testimonies, I think that would be amazing. A compilation of ex-statists, essentially. Like you see these compilations on YouTube of ex-vegans or ex-whatever. I want to create an ex-statist compilation. I want to see all these different people and have them deliver their perspectives so people can see more perspective, so people can see, well, why is it that all these people are talking about what they're talking about? How did they get to what information that they now share with us today? I think that would be a beautiful, beautiful thing. And you know, so many times, countlessly, and this goes into the fifth step on this list, the fifth thing of notice, the thing I'm gonna talk about is legality versus morality confrontations. Man, is there so many times where I talk to statists and they just freak out, even though it's just over morality. They go crazy. They don't want to talk about it. They don't want to answer questions, right? Or they just completely ignore you. They try to beat around the bush, and it's crazy. There's been times where I make an appeal to morality. I'm like, where's the conscience in this individual? I know it's there, but it's not there for the time being. They try to push it aside and ignore it and put their politics ahead of them, you know, and they play these games that they personally don't want to play, but they feel like they have to. And, you know, it makes me cry sometimes, you know, the amount of stress and pressures that people put on to me and say, well, what do you mean? You don't want to, you know, you don't like politics. Why don't you just leave America? You don't like it here. And I make videos about these topics, but do they care? No. And, you know, it just, it troubles me because I don't know how many people actually care about morality. And that goes into, like I said, the fifth thing on this list, which is, what if we can record these confrontations, show these people the hypocrisy, and then if other people look at it and say, well, man, I don't want to act like that, man, I don't want to. Look at this person acting so irrationally to somebody who's talking about morality. I think it would do such great wonders. People don't know what I have to deal with on a day-to-day basis facing statists or people in politics, but it's amazing what I run into. You know, some people are very open-minded and they give me the time of day, and other people don't give me the time of day at all. You know, maybe they get offended, but they don't want to look offended, right? So they just want to walk away from it. They want to ignore it. I definitely don't like ignorance on such a part. And so we have number four here, get involved with local newspapers and or the common law assembly and or third parties. Now, even if, let's say, these newspapers, parties, what have you, people within our statist, they are maybe looking for education, they're looking for information, and local newspapers will bring people to information because that's why they're reading the newspaper. Now, that could, again, that could be online or in real life, okay? But the common law assembly, same deal. These are people, however, that are escaping the system. These are people who see the system as inherently flawed. There's so many problems with it. So they're close. They're on the edge of understanding what freedom is. They're understanding all these concepts about the system. But what about the system that they're always in, the natural system, right? The freedom that is the world of nature around them that doesn't require any pieces of paper and special, you know, formatted paperwork and recordings and all this jazz, right? Looking even deeper toward the truth, which is understanding merely reality and morality, which, you know, we don't have to go out around and about saying, well, taxation is bad because of this or this or that. We can say it's bad because it's wrong. The same way we understand that statism is essentially slavery or the upholding of slavery, and we need to understand that, but that's a moral cause, right? And we talk about this on step two of the four steps to change the world for total freedom, and that is education of statism, not anything else, because statism targets the roots, that is slavery, that is looking at how do we actually create freedom. And so that's why I say total freedom. But when we have third parties, the same deal. These are libertarians. These are people that are closer to understanding what real freedom is, right? They're closer to being abolitionists and realizing slavery in its totality to say, hey, I'm not a slave. I'm not going to contribute to slavery either. We want freedom, and we want freedom, period, in all forms, right? But we want to understand that that freedom is going to first come from self-control, from education, of morality, and so maybe they can collaborate. Maybe you'll meet people within it that will also collaborate. Maybe they can join the summit. Maybe they can help contribute to the newspaper. There's so much potential here. Maybe there's people who are like, I'm sick of these mainstream local newspapers, and I want to start my own, and that would bridge a connection so that way more people can get this information out, right? Information that the mainstream press does not want anybody to hear. So this is all integral, and I think this is something I'm going to be considering as time moves on. I'm always considering, well, you know, where can I join this group or that group? Where's the individuals that are open to this information? And you know, there is always somebody. There's always somebody who's willing to question more than what meets the eye. Okay, so now we have number five, like I said, legality versus morality, confrontations campaign. Now, what does this mean? Okay, so legality versus morality, which is essentially what we're doing when we're saying, well, do you want to be a slave or do you not want to? Do you want to uphold slavery or do you not want to? And when we do confrontations, may you say, you know, We Are Change is a good example. They did a lot of confrontations in the past. You know, they would go up to politicians, they'll find people at airports, they'll go to rallies, they'll go to political parties, and they'll find these candidates, and they'll ask them really tough questions and see what they say and get it recorded. I think it'd be very interesting if we recorded the responses. Like I said, I deal with a lot of responses on a day-to-day basis, and what if those were recorded just so people can see what their fellow man is doing to people like me just talking about morality? I think it's just amazing, right? And then you can see, well, do these politicians really care about morality? That tells you a great deal of character about these people. Do they care about ending violence, essentially? Do they care about understanding what a right is if they claim to uphold rights, right? Do they claim to create rights that don't exist in nature or to have more rights than other people? How is that equality? These are really core questions, right? And those five questions I always put in my videos, the five questions by Larkin Rose, which is also in my book, Slavery Gone for Good. These are huge questions that also question the morality of the situation. And so many people in politics don't want to ask those questions. So if we can create confrontations, and again, with our network of the newspaper and the summit, that's amazing right there. That's incredible. And like I said, it could take a couple months for these events to start up. But once they're up and running and people are connected and they're sharing ideas and people are constantly doing so, I think then we have a lot of potential for a lot of these ideas where we can say, okay, let's start doing confrontations. Let's make this a campaign so that way we encourage everybody else to do the same thing. Like in Project Veritas, right? They say hashtag expose CNN or whatever, where they encourage people become insiders and find information and encourage whistleblowers to come out and expose footage, right? But that is what we can do, and we can create little campaigns and we can hold people accountable with a newspaper. You know, I don't want to make videos targeting certain individuals or starting a bunch of drama on the internet, but I think it's essential if we can do so in an educative manner and encourage people to free their own minds and help them do so, rather than creating a target and making so much pressure onto it. I think that would help quite a bit. You know, when there's a video on the web showing how you yourself responded to questions, and it wasn't done so for necessarily a public stunt, it was done so out of the care for the common good, I mean, people will expose themselves, right? We're not out there purposely trying to create pressure on people saying, well, look at this person, they're a statist and they believe in this and that, you know. And I understand that my target audience on my channel, Is a lot of people who follow Mark Passio and a lot of people who follow already anti-statist content, already anti-slavery content. And, you know, that is people, these are people who want freedom, and I understand that's my target market, so that's why I'm talking about these ideas. You know, and some of my videos are targeted toward the new person who wants to learn, and other videos are targeted toward, you know, hey, here we are. This is the information we have. Now, what do we do with it? Because it's one to know the truth and another to know how to act for the truth. These are very big ideas. So there's other ideas I have, and there's even more than this, but I wanted to create a truth in music radio. I don't see any 24-hour radio around the world sharing truth music. I mean, there's so many people who are so passionate about music, but yet we don't have a 24-hour live stream of it. And I think that'd be very cool, because then it's constantly going, and people love music, and it can appeal to them depending on the genre, and we can separate by genre. If you want to see an example, I already created a channel called Truth in Music Radio, or Truth in Music Electronic Radio, which stands for timer, because, you know, everything is a timer, essentially, even just music. So that is a very interesting idea that I never really got off its feet, but maybe there's potential for that in the future, or maybe somebody wants to take that up and reach out to me because they're passionate about music. Feel free to let me know. But another idea is a clips channel, right? Is, let's say you have Mark Passio. He puts out 3-hour, you know, long presentations every single week. I'm putting out constantly hours worth of content. Who can clip that and turn that into separate videos? Because you can get a lot of views that way. You know, you're mentioning this person, that person, this person, and you can put out pretty much a video every single day. If you're doing that, they're just small segments. You're not even the one producing it. You're just clipping it and posting it out there, but it helps get the message out to more people. This can be a very powerful means of communication, of education, and a lot of people do this on different channels where they create clips or even just compile clips, and that is a very powerful thing if you can deal with certain topics or, like I said, certain people. So there's like a channel out there called Jason A, where like every single thumbnail and every single title is like, you won't believe what's happening in the world, or you, this world has never seen this coming, or they were warned, you know, like some clickbaity titles, but it works, and it gets people intrigued, and the clips are all focused on different topics. You can take that type of approach, or you can take the approach of, I'm just going to post clips, and maybe I'm just going to edit the thumbnail a little bit. You got to play around with it, right? We got to experiment with these ideas. Another thing is, and this has a lot of experimentation, is handing out material, right? I wrote books, I have brochures that people can download, I have business cards that people can print, and all this stuff, even just the flag, right, on NITA.one, all this stuff is to share material and to say, well, here is material and here's information you've never seen before. So if we can do that through many different means, fantastic, and I encourage people to customize it to their own free will fruition, because it's really good if you can put your own artistic expertise into this, or just your expertise in general. And any one of these ideas, they're all practical. These are all ideas that we can absolutely do, and anybody with a current network now can make this happen immediately, right? But they have to be the one to say, let's do it, let's motivate people, let's inspire them, let's provide them with some sort of structure to do it, right? I'm saying, well, this is how the summit works, this is how the newspaper works. I'm providing some sort of structure, and then we can move that into the world, just like the abolitionists did in the 1800s with their newspapers, and say, well, here, this is why slavery is immoral, this is why it needs to be abolished. And how is it going to be abolished? By slave owners getting rid of their slaves, or by the slaves freeing themselves? And right, and that brings us to step 3 and step 4 of the 4 steps. Okay, now the last idea here to share is just basically, I'm going to be doing videos on all parts of my books. My books have a lot of content within them. They have sections and topics that I figured they can be all separate videos. So these are pretty much all the things I'm going to be doing looking forward in the next, like I said, couple months and years. I'm interested in your ideas and what you think of my ideas and how you would want to also collaborate with me. Please share that with me. If you have any questions about these ideas, you'll hear more about them as time moves on. Keep in mind, the summit is number one. This is pretty much in order of how I'm going to do things, except I would say the videos on all parts of my books could be actually within all of these. Okay, and you know, me getting involved with real life things in the local newspapers, I'm always trying to find those opportunities. You know, I don't say, okay, I'm gonna do it later. No, I'm gonna try my best right now, everything I can. So that's why I make this video. That's why I want to put it out all on the table, and I hope you appreciate these perspectives, these ideas. Thank you very much. This is Corey at Angelot. Nature is the answer.